Alhamdulillah. Eidul Adha. So that's the third Jama now, right?
Yes, inshallah.
Alhamdulillah. What? Abba, you got any message you want to share to those who are not able to perform Eid prayer today, wherever they are, because of?
Actually, I mean, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam responded to those who are not able to do it. The same response he gave to those people who could not participate in Tabuk. And he said to them, who could do it? Right now there are people in Medina. They are not here with you. They don't go through the hardship you did go through, but they are here with the reward. Because they are hard with you, but their bodies and financial condition did not allow them. As Allah said, especially with this aid, your taqwa will reach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not the physical presence, not the blood of the animal or the meat, but the piety from you will reach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You just send it from your heart.
Sure.
And that because the masjid is not the destination. The Kaaba is not the destination. That is a physical destination only. But the real destination is wherever we are, we aim Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Inshallah.
And we reach it.
Inshallah. Eid Mubarak.
Eid Mubarak.
Yes, you want to add anything?
Assalamu alaikum.
Like you said, this is one of the school administrators. What's happening to your school?
Eid Mubarak to everyone.
Eid Mubarak.
Alhamdulillah, it has been a very special day for us.
Yeah.
It has had its challenge.
Yeah.
Some of our brothers and sisters were unable to stay because of work restrictions. But some of us we could manage. So inshallah, next Eid we were hoping that things will be different. Jazakallah khairan, assalamu alaikum, and Eid Mubarak to everyone.
Eid Mubarak to your family. This is Brother Suhail Khan, President of the Executive Committee of the Canberra Islamic Center, which encompasses the Sabah Al Ahmad Masjid and Islamic Education Center. Brother Suhail, people are saying the executive committee has done an amazing job to make sure they are able to cater for the hundreds and hundreds of people to perform Eid when some of their compatriots within Australia are not able to do so. What happened? How were you able to organize such a fantastic event, and what message do you have for the community?
Alhamdulillah, we've got a very good executive committee. Brother Ali Akbar, Brother Shamsul Huda, they are all here to help. Of course, Brother Siar and others. And it has been tiring for us, but alhamdulillah, we decided to have three jamaats, then we had to make it to four. And now I don't know how many jamaats will be there, because we are already on to the third one. And we'll keep going till all the people have prayed.
Alhamdulillah.
So inshallah, it will be a long day for us, but an enjoyable day, day full of barakah.
Alhamdulillah. Another thing that's been cited is about the consistency about the message coming from the executive committee.
The only message we have got is it's a very special time.
Yeah.
We have to sacrifice in the sense that we can't have social gatherings, etc. But we will follow all the law of the land, and inshallah, we will come out of this safely. Everyone will be happy.
Inshallah. Ayyakum, akira. Alhamdulillah, you just heard from President of the EC, the Imam, and the Principal of the Sunday School. The third Jama is getting ready, inshallah. I would like to go and also interview our assistant Imam, Brother Muhammadin, who is waiting here. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. How are you, Sheikh? This is Brother Muhammad in Maida. He's getting ready. He's the assistant imam, and he's going to be the imam for the third jama'ah. This is a very special occasion, Brother Muhammadin. But alhamdulillah, the executive committee has done an amazing job to make sure at least four jama'ahs performed here to cater for a large majority of the people. Do you have any message for the Ummah, especially about those who have not been fortunate to perform Eid this year due to all everything that is going around?
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. And this is part of the things I'll talk about soon in my khutbah insha'Allah ta'ala. We have to remember that this day is a reminder for us, a day of sacrificing, the day of the story of Ismail alayhi salam, when Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala told his father to slaughter him. And what he told him, Satajiduni insha'Allah min as-sabirin, you will find me among those one who are patient. So Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala always test us in this life. خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. Is him who created death and life to see which one of us will have good deeds. Yeah. Brothers, this is a test for all the Ummah, that we can see some people cannot perform Hajj, but we have to read what is behind us and go back to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, and we say as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allahumma in lam yakun bika ghadabun alayya fala ubali. Oh Allah, if you are not angry with us, we don't care about what happened. The most important that Allah is not angry with us. And if He is, we have to go back to Him, seek refuge to Him, and ask forgiveness. Ask forgiveness from other people and from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. So this problem will pass, as lots of problems pass, inshallah.
Inshallah. Jazakallah khair, inshallah.